there's 750,000 medical patients across the state of Florida, and cannabis should be treated and be as accessible as anything is at local pharmacies.
Medical marijuana dispensaries could soon be on the way to parts of Collier County. Right now, commissioners are talking about allowing the stores outside of Naples and Marco Island.
NBC2's Ryan Arbogast is live at the meeting at Collier Growth Management Development Services in Naples.
Kelly, I've seen a number of people walk into the building, and a few of them have told me that they're actually going to the meeting, but it's been relatively quiet. Today marks the first day of discussions for medical marijuana dispensaries in unincorporated Collier County. The advocates that I talk to say it's time for Collier to see a green light.
There's 750,000 medical patients across the state of Florida, and cannabis should be treated and be as accessible as anything is a local pharmacy. So, the same way a Walgreens or a CVS or a Rite Aid can open in a community, dispensary should have that same kind of access for those patients.
Jason Irks represents Sunnyside Dispensaries. They sell medical marijuana at 17 locations in Florida, including a shop in Bonita Springs, one of the closest to Collier County.
I mean, we're open-minded to expanding wherever, there's patient demand. And, right now those patients are driving to our store in Bonita Springs, and we certainly want to get them access to their medicine and make their lives easier.
There are tens of thousands of medical marijuana users in Collier. Nicholas Garrelly from My Florida Green has helped at least 20,000 of them, getting them cards to deal with mental illness and pain.
Patients with debilitating conditions shouldn't have to drive out of their county to purchase medicine.
The medical marijuana meeting tonight could eventually push a vote to the county commission. One of those votes is Bill McDaniel.
And it's up to the individual choice.
For me.
I have always advocated for the individual choice. I don't think it's up to the government to tell you yes or no on what's good for you or not.
Commissioner McDaniel says he's not positive if this is going to even come to a vote, let alone pass. But if it does, he said he's interested in taking the tax dollars Collier County would get from a program like this and reinvesting them into mental health resources.
So, Ryan, is there any kind of timeline as to when this decision will be made and when it could actually happen?
Yeah, so I've heard around mid to late fall is what the commissioners are talking about now, but there's a lot of hoops to jump through. It has to go from the commission meeting tonight to the county commission to an eventual vote. So there's a lot of hoops to jump through before we see any action on this. Reporting live in Naples, Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.